Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel podcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today we have a question sent in by David. He's interested in creating a pivot table, but his data violates the rules for pivot tables. I always say that you need transactional data. You don't want to have a summary of your data. So here we have months going across the headings. That is always bad when you want to try and create a pivot table from this data. There's a really obscure trick, and I got this from Mike Alexander. Mike is my co-author on the Pivot Table Data Crunching books. I'm not sure exactly where he picked this up from, but it's a pretty cool trick to take this data that's formatted and create transactional data out of it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a pivot table, data, pivot table, and pivot chart report. But in the first step, I'm going to choose multiple consolidation ranges. This is one that we hardly ever talk about, not many people use. We'll click Next, say that we will allow Excel to create a single page for me, click Next. Specify where my data is. So my data is here. Click Add. Click Next. Okay, and now we're back in step three of the pivot table wizard. I'll just click Finish, and I get a very boring pivot table. But here is the amazing trick. You know that if you double click any cell in a pivot table, you get a new worksheet showing all of the data that makes up that cell. So what we want to do is go to the grand total for rows, grand total for columns, double click that cell, and now we have our original data set, but it's been spun into one row per every intersection of rows and columns. Kind of amazing that that works, but it is a great way to take data which is formatted with months going across and to create a data set that's now suitable for creating a pivot table from. Hey, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.